Hi, this is Thomas Lefebvre from the Instructional Media Center at the Mississippi State University Libraries, and in this tutorial we'll be looking at Camtasia Studio. When you first open Camtasia, you're greeted with a welcome screen. This gives you the option to record the screen, import media, or open recent projects. We're going to begin by clicking on Record the Screen. Clicking on Record the Screen will open the Camtasia recorder. Here in the recorder, you can choose to record the full screen, or you can select a custom screen size. In this case, I'm going to make this Illustrator window a little bit smaller, and I'm going to choose Custom and set this to the 720p HD widescreen. And another helpful feature of this custom area is that you can choose Lock to Application. This will then resize your window to actually fit within this recording screen. You can choose to enable your webcam, and you can also select which audio device you'll be using. In this case, I have a dedicated microphone set up, so I want to make sure that that's selected here. You can also choose whether you want to record the system audio or not. Once your settings are correct, you can then hit record. A countdown will begin, letting you know that you can press F10 to stop the recording. Now you can proceed with recording your video. When you are finished with your recording, either press F10 on the keyboard or click on the Camtasia recorder on the taskbar. Here, you can also choose to pause your video, and you can also choose to stop. If you don't like the video so far, you can hit delete and just begin again. Once you click stop, it will create your video file. After you stop your recording, you will be given a preview. You can use this to advance through and see the tutorial as it is before any edits are made. And once you're happy with it, you can then choose Save and Edit. When you click Save and Edit, this will then let you name the video file. After you save the file, it will then open in the Camtasia editor. When your recording opens in the Camtasia editor, you may be asked about the editing dimensions. This happens when you've recorded a custom or full screen size that is not proportionate with the standard video dimensions. You can choose a size from the drop-down list, or you can enter your own custom dimensions. You can also choose a background color that will show if you remove the video from the canvas. Once you've set your editing dimensions, click OK. If you need to go back and readjust these editing dimensions, this can be found with this button here at the top that shows you your editing dimensions, and by clicking this button, it will bring that dialog back. Once you've set those dimensions, it's now time to save your file. Go to File, Save Project, and then give your file a name. This saves your file as a Camtasia Studio project, or a .camproj. Click Save. A window will appear to remind you that you've only saved your project, you've not actually produced your video, and we'll get to that step shortly. Click OK. A Camtasia Studio project file is made up of raw video files, in this case, the TechSmith recording file, or the TREC file, and any edits that you've made on the timeline. Think of this as a recipe that will be used later to create your final video. The timeline at the bottom of the screen shows our recording. In this case, I have three tracks that were recorded. Track 3 contains the video and audio from my webcam, track 2 contains the screen recording, and track 1 contains the system audio. Each of these tracks can be edited individually. For example, I could select my webcam video, and I could reposition this on the screen. Or I can use the transform handles to actually increase the size or decrease it. You will also notice that this track contains both video and audio. You can see the audio waves here at the bottom of the track. If I want to separate this, I can right-click on this track and choose Separate Video and Audio. This will create a new separate track for the audio. Now that the audio is separated, I can select the webcam video, and if I want to remove it completely, I can just press delete, and it will delete that from the timeline. Now, as the video plays, it will just walk through the screen capture and just play the audio. You can relocate tracks. I can click on the audio, and I could drag it down to the third track to keep these together. To remove different portions of this video, Use the playhead and the green and red sides, the start and finish markers, and select parts of the video that you want to trim out. Here I'm going to trim out the beginning so it just starts with the tutorial. And I'm going to use the scissors or Control X on your keyboard to cut. And now when I press play, I will see that it starts now with that tutorial. This can also be used to edit out mistakes that may have been made. Here I can click in the middle and maybe drag the selection end to a certain point. And then again, using the scissors or Control X on your keyboard, just cut that section out of the tracks. Once these edits have been made, you may want to add additional elements to your tutorial. To add a title clip, click on the library folder and browse to the Title Clips Simple folder. Here I can choose a color that I want for my background, and if you double-click on one of these, you'll be able to see what that looks like. When you've selected the clip you want, click and drag it down to the timeline. Now, in working with this timeline, what you want to do is just make sure that everything lines up where you want it. You can use your zoom tools to zoom in and out and adjust where each of these happens on the timeline. Here I can select track 3, 2, and 1, and I'm going to click and drag so that they match up with the ending transition of my title clip. Now if I move my playhead back to the beginning and click play, you can see how that title will work. To edit this title, double-click it on the timeline. So we'll open up the different options, and if you scroll down, this is where you can edit the text. As your tutorial is progressing, you may notice that you want to zoom in on different parts of your screen. This is done using the Zoom and Pan tab. Move the playhead to where you want the zoom to begin. Here, I'm going to have it zoom in on this window that appears. Using the Zoom and Pan area, click and drag the handles to zoom in on the area you're interested in. Once this is done, you'll notice that it adds that to the timeline as this little arrow. And now if I back up and play this again, you'll notice that it zooms in on that window. When you're ready for this to zoom back out, just use the Zoom and Pan options again. And to go back to full screen, use this little Scale Media to Fit Entire Canvas button. Now it will hold that level until you add another zoom and pan. Callouts can also be added. Callouts are graphics that appear in the video to draw attention to important objects or processes in videos. Click the drop-down arrow to see all of the callouts available. To add a callout, make sure that no track is selected, then use your drop-down arrow and select the callout that you want. Here I'm going to add just a circle to draw a circle around this object in the video. Position the callout and resize it on the screen. And using the callout properties, you can change the length of the draw time, and also if you want it to fade out, how long that will take. You can change the color, and you can add effects like a shadow. Now if I move my playhead back a few frames and hit play, we can see that now that motion will draw in, and then after a few seconds, it will fade out. To adjust the duration of this callout, click and drag at the sides of the callout on its track to either lengthen or shorten the amount of time that it's displayed. To add a transition, find a spot where two clips come together. If you've been using the cut method to edit your video, you may need to unstitch the clips. Right-click between the two clips and select Unstitch. Now, select the transition that you'd like to use and drag it between the clips. Once you've made your edits and you're ready to produce your file, use the Produce and Share menu and choose the file type that you want. If you have a YouTube account already, you can go ahead and put in that information and it will upload it for you. Or if you just need the video file, you can choose this HD MP4 only. Click Next. Choose the folder where you'd like your video to be saved. click Finish, and allow Camtasia to render the video. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below, or you can visit our website at library.msstate.edu/imc for our contact information and additional handouts and tutorials. Thanks for watching.